40 soccer fans are now believed to have died in this afternoon's massive blaze, which spread, according to one survivor, like a flash through the main stand at Bradford City Football Ground. Up to 200 more people were injured. Some are badly burnt. The 77-year-old wooden stand was destroyed after a small fire at the back of the stadium grew into an inferno in under 5 minutes. It happened during Bradford's third division match against Lincoln. The fire brigade said tonight the doors at the rear of the stand were all probably padlocked. Police say many people were crushed against the gates. Officials say there were no fire extinguishers inside the stand because of previous problems of fans setting them off maliciously. It's thought that many of those who died were trapped at the back or under the stand, where they'd gone just before the fire broke out near half-time. Police don't know how the blaze started. John Helm of Yorkshire Television was commentating on the match when he saw the fire start.
And we've actually got a fire in the stand on the far side of the ground. And that looks very nasty indeed. Now, the police have gone over there to try and quell the fire, and they're frantically getting some of the supporters out. Now, these are extraordinary scenes at Valley Parade. It's supposed to be a day of celebration. One hopes the stand doesn't burn down. But now that fire is beginning to rage. And the 2,500 people in that stand are panicking. They are frantic to get out. And these are disastrous scenes for the club. One can feel the heat. And that is a catastrophic sight for Bradford City Football Club. The whole stand is going up in flames, and that person there looks to be burning. And the timbers are coming down onto the ground, and this is horrific. This was supposed to be a day of utter joy, triumph and celebration. It's turning into a nightmare. There is a policeman on fire there. He's managed to quell that. The roof is caving in. The smoke, the black pall of smoke is rising hundreds of feet in the air. And the whole place is scorching. The police have done a manful job because the rafters have been coming down on them, and you can see the exhaustion and the panic on the faces of some of those people there. And this is a burning hell. And look at that. Oh, the poor man. Oh, this is awful. The police desperately trying to save the life of a supporter. He'd come to watch the football. This is human tragedy. 10 minutes ago, we were looking at a football game. I now look at a sad and tragic sight.
Going to the tea stand, I saw the fire coming on. I got onto the pitch, and when most people were nearly out, I saw a fella at the front of the stand on fire. I went to try helping him out, and as I got close, it was that hot, I could hardly reach him. My head started blistering within feet of him, and he was up in flames.
Did anybody get him out, do you know?
Yes, we got him out. He got out okay, but he looked in a very bad way.
Well, what we did, we moved to the front, and when we got over the barrier, we saw three or four people with the hair on fire. So I left him with the lad, and the people were coming across. There were one chap with his legs trapped with because the crowds were coming over, and we just pulled them over. We didn't care how we pulled them over, we just pulled them over.
An hour after the blaze first broke out, more than 100 firemen were still damping down the smouldering stand. Wood and metal remained red hot, preventing a full-scale search of the wreckage. On the pitch, police had begun the task of identifying the belongings of those who'd fled in terror. Many were horrified by what they'd seen.
Some of my officers were putting coats over their heads and trying to drag people out, and one of my inspectors got a woman halfway out and couldn't hang on to her, and she just went. But I can only describe it as a terrible tragedy. Some of my officers have been in tears this afternoon, and that shows the extent of the tragedy when a policeman cries over something like this.
In the streets outside, players and fans stood dazed, unable to take in what had happened.
The people jumping out on fire, you know, you couldn't do a great deal for them, you know, if we're just totally on fire, you know, but, you know, this is, you know, it's eclipsed to a season, it's, you know, it's just been so downhearted today, you know. It ought to be such a happy day today for people of Bradford, you know, but it's just come down in such a day of gloom.
Casualties, many with serious burns, were treated at three local hospitals.
And everybody was fighting to get onto the field, you see.
And your clothes were actually on fire.
And my clothes were on fire.
Is your coat still...
Yeah.
How badly... Did you got badly burnt?
I have got very bad, and on my back as well.
Back at the ground, anxious relatives waited for news of those still unaccounted for, as firemen began the grim task of combing through what remained of the stand. Many of the bodies recovered were close to the turnstiles at the rear of the stand, where a crowd had formed as the fans struggled to get out. Most were so badly burnt that identification was almost impossible. The recovery operation is expected to last well into this evening. Robert Hall for ITN, Bradford.
At the grounds tonight, units from the police and fire brigades are still engaged in the grim task of picking through the charred wreckage of the wooden main stand. The fire was so intense, it's made it difficult to detect the victims amongst the ashes. Various remains have been collected together and covered by sheets. The police estimate it will take them several days to complete the search. Forensic experts have been called in to examine what evidence has been left by the intense heat. The firemen have been on the scene now for nearly 6 hours. The shock and exhaustion on their faces is clear. The question the forensic experts want to answer is what caused the fire to spread so rapidly? Was it a case of arson or simply a tragic accident? A 24-hour police guard is being mounted around the grounds. It's still impossible to say how many bodies may lie beneath the still smouldering wreckage. David Chater, ITN, in Bradford.